Hello children, welcome back to the e-learning class. Today we are going to see the remaining part of vocabulary and grammar. So let us go to the textual page, page number 53. Question number 4. Look at the following pictures and predict what will happen next. Draw or write in the given space. Children, here you have to observe the picture and predict, means say or estimate that what will happen in the future or will be a consequence of something. Children, here one example has done for you already. A rabbit sees a fresh red carrot. Now children, now you can think what will happen in the next. Definitely, the rabbit eats the carrot. Now, you have to observe the picture and read the given sentences here. And then, you have to predict what will happen in the next, draw and write the sentences. Do it by your own. Let us go to the next page, page number 54. I revise. Question number 1. Circle the prepositions in the given sentences. Question number 2. Read the following sentences and fill up the blanks using appropriate prepositions. Now children, let us revise prepositions. Position words. Preposition is a word that tells us where a person, place, animal or thing is. It means preposition tells us the position of a noun or pronoun. So, they are called position words. A preposition is a word which shows the relation between a noun or pronoun and some other word in a sentence. Also, we can say, children, the words which show place or position are called prepositions. So children, let us see the examples. The ball is in the basket. Children, once again, I am going to repeat. The ball is in the basket. The ball is inside the cupboard. The ball is inside the cupboard. The ball is on the table. The ball is on the table. The ball is under the table. The ball is under the table. The table is below the fan. The table is below the fan. Children, see, it is exactly below the fan. Children, here are two objects, fan and table. So, we have to level up the objects, differentiating from high to low. So, then we can say it is below. The table is below the fan. Here I level up the object from high to low. Below means one object is down in respect of other object. The table is below the fan. The fan is above the table. The fan is above the table. Children, we usually use above when something is higher than something else and both the things are stable at their places. They are not movable. They are stable on their places. The ball is behind the basket. The ball is behind the basket. The ball is in front of the basket. The ball is in front of the basket.
The ball is outside the basket. The ball is outside the basket. The ball is near the basket. The ball is near the basket.
The ball is far from the basket. The ball is far from the basket.
The balls are around the basket. The balls are around the basket.
Children, see, it is a toy cat. But we will do along with this activity to understand preposition upon. Okay, so let us start. The cat jumped upon the table. The cat jumped upon the table. Here the cat is movable. Okay, so the movement is going on from down to the up. Okay, it is up and it is going to be placed on table. So on. Once again, the cat is movable. The movement is going on. The cat jumped up on the table and it stable on the table. So on. Once again, children, I'm going to repeat the same. The cat jumped upon the table. Understood here, children?
Children, with this toy cat, one more activity we are going to do to understand the preposition over. Okay, so let us start. The cat jumped over the table. Once again, children, I am going to repeat. The cat jumped over the table.
Here, children, the cat is moving from one place to another, and while it is going from one place to another, it is going over the table and it is not going to touch the surface of the table, and it is coming down to the another side. The cat jumped over the table. I hope, children, you understood the concept.
The ball is between the baskets. The ball is between the baskets. Also, we can say, children, the ball is between the two baskets. The ball is between the two baskets. Children, see, the ball is placed between the two baskets.
Now, children, let us do one activity to understand prepositions before, after, and between. So let us start one by one. Here I have three toys with me: a teddy bear, a toy car, and a doll. So let us start. The teddy bear is placed before the car. The teddy bear is placed before the car. Okay, now let us go to the next. The doll is placed after the car. Okay, the doll is placed after the car. Thus, the car is placed between the teddy bear and the doll. The car is placed between the teddy bear and the doll.
So, children, here before, after, and between, these words are telling us the positions of the toys. So they are prepositions or position words.
Now, children, let us see the next preposition, at. At is used with definite point of time. Let us see few examples. The sun shines brightly at noon. Noon time is the definite point of time. So, at preposition is used here. Let us see the next. He reached the school at 7 a.m. Children, here 7 a.m. it also denotes morning time, so at preposition is used here. The baby sleeps at night. Children, here night word is also telling us or denotes the time. So, at preposition is used here. Children, we also use at preposition when we speak about specific or small locations. For example, they have a pet at their house. Now children, based on your understanding, complete the questions by your own. Here we will stop. Let us meet in the next e-learning class. Till the time, stay home, stay safe. Thanks for watching.